are born or made? Fellow Toastmasters, a very good afternoon to all of you. There was a young boy who had a companion who was his brother's classmate. His elder brother and mother warned him of the bad company. Nevertheless, the boy pleaded that he knew about the friend's weaknesses and his association was meant to reform the friend. He emphasized that the friend can in no way make him astray from his family beliefs, values and traditions. The friend was very strong and daring. He could run long distances and he could do it like really extraordinary speed. He was an adept in long and high jumping. Whereas the boy, he could never run or jump. He was moreover haunted with the fear of thieves, serpents, ghosts. He would never step out of the door during night. Darkness was a terror for him. The friend explained to the boy that people who do not eat meat are weak. The boy was astonished with that at the beginning. Over a period of time, the friend insisted that the boy should give it a try and see if it would work for him. Over a period of time, with long and exhaustive conversations, his friend impressed upon the boy that meat eating was not bad and it would make him strong and daring. Finally, one day was fixed to begin the experiment. The boy's family was Vaishnava's family, so the deal had to be done in secrecy. A lonely place by the side of the river was selected, and the boy saw meat for the first time in his life at that spot. After the meal that night, the boy had a feeling of a live goat bleating inside him and he jumped out of the bed. Later, he convinced himself, saying meat eating is indeed good for him and will make him strong. Friends, don't you think this is the story of an ordinary child? Yes. Fast forward a few years, this ordinary, gullible and easily gullible, who can be carried away easily, has grown up to be a lawyer. In the courtroom, he stood up to examine the plaintiff's witnesses. As he stood up, his heart sank into his boots. His head was reeling and he felt the courtroom was like a spinning ball. He could think of no question to ask. The judge and his colleagues laughed, but he seen none of that. He sat down and told the client to take back the money and look for another lawyer. This was the story of an ordinary, below average performer. By now, I am sure most of you have guessed whom I am talking about. It is none other than our Bapu, Mahatma Gandhi. Later in his life, he stood for a cause. He stood for free India, India being free from British. And the path he chose, or the methodology that he chose, was of Satyagraha, which is a non-violent approach. Civil disobedience movement, or the non-cooperation movement, or the Quit India movement are a few examples of how he used this methodology. His speeches were very powerful and it brought new spirit to the whole nation. Self-sacrifice and service have become the religion of the nation. He led the India freedom struggle for India. During that time, he has done fasting, he marched on his foot, and he was even jailed. And the end of it, there was a success. And the nation became free. India became free on 14th of August 1947, midnight. Why am I sharing this with you? It's definitely not to preach you to take on Satyagraha, and it's definitely not to repeat the history for you. If you take any of the leaders, Mahatma Gandhi or any of the social reformers, one thing that you see is that they took on extraordinarily big problem that's prevalent at their times. And the way they approached is to choose a methodology that's relevant, required at that point in time, and whatever is most appropriate. And they put their heart, soul and life into making that true. And naturally people followed them and people gave all their support to them. And they started to grow up as leaders. If you look at Mahatma Gandhi, he turned out to be a political figure, he was a social reformer, a humanist, and a visionary who could stand for the dignity of mankind. And any person who is taking that leadership is the one who turns out to be a leader. It doesn't require them to be inborn with a certain skill, nor does it require them to possess a certain trait that they train themselves in. They take up a challenge or a problem and they stand for it with all the courage and strength and to make it success. Right? After sharing this, fellow Toastmasters, I want you to take a look around you, open your eyes, take a look around you where there is a problem or a need that might be staring at you in your community or your society, and you allow generously your leadership to make a change that is required to alter the status quo of whatever is so right now. I conclude by quoting Henry Kissinger saying, "The leader is a person who takes his people to a place where they have never been, from a place where they are right now." Thank you.